Welcome, brothers and sisters, to the celebration of the Triduum. As we begin on this night, especially, we begin with the Lord's Supper. And we hear again that Jesus will wash his disciples' feet, telling us the meaning of what loving service can be. Today, Jesus gives to the church the institution of the priesthood and the gift of the Eucharist. Today, the Lord accepts the Father's will. Lay down his life so that we may have life. And so we hear in the entrance antiphon, we should glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whom is our salvation, life, and resurrection. Through him we are saved and delivered. And so let us begin as a people of profound faith and love as we now step into these 3 days. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate now the memorial of the Lord's Supper, let us be mindful of his immense love for his Father and for each one of us. Lord Jesus, you freed your people from slavery. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you redeemed your people from sin. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you washed the apostles' feet. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And let us now praise our God in which we have not done since the beginning of the season of Lent. As we say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. And in our prayers this evening, we pray for one another. We pray for the parish here of St. Mary's in Greensboro, North Carolina. We pray for those whom we are connected to and all those who have no one to pray for them. As we now come to this altar to remember God's great love in his Son, Jesus. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us now be open to hear the words that our Lord has written for us this evening. A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, this month shall stand at the head of your calendar.
You shall reckon it the first month of the year to the whole community of Israel. On the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. The same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations will celebrate, with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord. We respond to God's word in Psalm 116. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you. Praise and honor to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." And Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now we come to this first evening of the Holy Triduum, my friends, in a world that has radically changed. No longer are we able to gather in our upper room, nor to see the ritual action of washing the feet, reminding us of the example of Christ-like service that we are to take up. We will not hear familiar songs or to receive the actual body and blood of Christ that is instituted for us, or actually to be a part of the procession of the Eucharist to another place, and to rest before the Eucharist with an altar decorated with lights and beauty amidst our brothers and sisters. No, we cannot do that this year, but we can still come this evening and hear and sing a bit together from the book of Exodus about this celebration of the Passover, where we encounter really the God who knows no boundaries for our deliverance, for our protection, for our nourishment and service. Together, we can actually hear and sing again that the initiative to do all of these things is actually God's, that the prodigal generosity in saving his people is God's. The self-emptying is God's. And for no other reason but love does God offer us salvation. For no other reason but love does God pass over our brokenness and feeds us and sets us free with mercy and forgiveness and leads us to a new destiny of hope that we will hear and celebrate in these coming days. And then tonight, we did hear the psalmist sing, "How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me?" And our response can actually be to do as he has done, to take the cup of salvation, to sing thanksgiving, the meaning and heart of what we celebrate in Eucharist. And when we sing together, we give thanks and open ourselves into the graciousness of God. We open ourselves to the call of the Lord in each Eucharist that we celebrate, that our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of the Lamb, our call to truly know the depth of his love. Tonight, we hear once again that simple gifts of wheat and wine
will we embrace God's sacrificial love. We remember to celebrate a loving presence in Lion Week, anticipating a future as we open ourselves to become that which we receive in Christ, to actually be food for the hungry and drink for the thirsty. We gather this night, which we must sing, that the risen and exalted Lord continually gives what the dying Jesus gave us once for all. And every time, my friends, that we gather in Thanksgiving in the quiet of our own homes this year, allowing the love that God has poured out upon us, we can echo the word of the Lord this night. Take and eat. Take and drink. Become. And be with the one who knows no boundaries, to touch our lives with that love, that mercy, that forgiveness. And when we hear and then understand that as Jesus trades in his cloak of divinity for a towel to dry the feet of those who at the level of rodents was serving, but who would walk in their day as it is in our day, the good news of his death and resurrection, he did so in loving preference for all who would, by our very deeds, enact on as I have done, so you must also do. This year, you're invited to make your home the upper room. Be the basin and the pitcher, the towels washed and others' feet in service. Return to the Lord all the good he has done, and above all, give thanks, really, for the prodigal love that is shown each time we receive and hope to become in the Lord by doing what he has done in the Eucharist that we celebrate. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, at this time, we do share the faith of what we believe and hope in. And so let us now stand and continue to profess the Apostles' Creed with saying, I believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We are people who are gathered to pray. It is in remembrance that we have gathered. It is in humility that we look to God. It is in confidence that we now pray for the church and the world. For the church, that we reveal that we are the body of Christ, faithful to the witness of Christ, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all peoples who are facing food and medicine shortages and have grown fearful in their hearts, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who are ill and have died from the coronavirus, for all who are currently suffering physical, mental, and spiritual anguish, for their caregivers and first responders, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For families in St. Mary's Parish who are battling addictions and abusive relationships, especially in this time of quarantine, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have asked for our prayers and generosity, especially the poor and stranger that comes to our church doors, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all peoples who are at risk of losing their jobs and livelihoods during this pandemic, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our parish family to embrace the call to connect with our neighbors and loved ones, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who will gather around the table of the Lord, find renewed inspiration in serving one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the members of St. Mary's family who have experienced the loss of a loved one this past week, and for the intention of this Mass, for the persons of St. Mary's, and for all those whom you hold in the depth of your hearts and hands, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. God have mercy, you gave us your Son for our Paschal Lamb. Return in trust and join our concerns together and place them in confident trust in Jesus Christ, our Lord, forever and ever.
Amen.
This year I'd like to do something a little different. I'd like to do a prayer for priests. Usually at this time we also recognize that on this night we do recognize the institution of the priesthood who continues to share the body and blood of the Lord and his word with those who gather. So let me pray for all of our priests here at St. Mary's and for all of the priests who serve us. Lord Jesus, present in the most blessed sacrament and living perpetually among us through your priests, grant that the words of your priests may be only your words, that their gestures be only your gestures, and that their lives be true reflections of your life. Grant that they may be men who speak to God on behalf of his people and speak to his people of God. Grant that they may be courageous in service, serving the Church as she asks to be served. And we pray that your Holy Mother Mary, present throughout your life, may be ever present in the lives of your priests. And we ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
At your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these set mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, and eternal God through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong,
And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the working and power of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. From the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave it to it, the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. And may he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on all the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We know the Savior's command. We have been formed by his divine teaching on love. So let us dare pray, saying together as his disciples, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer that sign of Christ's peace. Yubinyan. And la paz contigo, la paz contigo. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei. Behold the profound love of our God, in whom he sent his Son as the Lamb to take away the sins of this world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. communion song, and Antiphon says, "This is the body that will be given up for you. This is the chalice of the new covenant in my blood, says the Lord. Do this whenever you receive it in memory of me." Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, just one announcement. Please, tomorrow we here at the parish will be celebrating the Stations of the Cross in the predominant languages that are here. 12 o'clock we will do the Stations of the Cross in English. At 1 we will do these Stations of the Cross in Spanish. And at 2 we will do the Stations of the Cross in Vietnamese. Starting at 4 o'clock we will have the Good Friday service in English, at 5:30 in Spanish, and at 7 in Vietnamese. We thank you for gathering here together. We also continue to pray for you, and we ask that you pray for one another as we continue now to walk and journey in this time, which can at some moments can be fearful, and yet we are a people of hope and of faith. So let us end our time together as we sing, "Hail, Holy God, we praise thy name," as we place back again the Eucharist in the tabernacle that we will use. And so take the time also that you believe that you will need to pray before the Blessed Sacrament as we get ready for the next Mass at 5:30. God bless you and keep you.
Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord, of all, we bow before thee. All thy work, thy scepter claim. All in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy bestowing.